ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, this beautiful month of Ramadan, Allah Almighty wants us to do as much as we can and to push ourselves. How much of Quran did you read today? That's a question. How much extra prayer did you fulfill today? What did you do in terms of adhkar and the remembrance of Allah today? What extra acts of worship have you done? Did you give a charity today, even if it means a little bit? Did you visit a sick person or pray for them or call them or message them to find out how they're doing and to try and boost the way they felt? Did you call someone who might have lost a loved one and express your condolences and sympathies and perhaps say a dua for them? All of these are acts of worship that are taken seriously in Islam. And the month of Ramadan comes by in order for us to get closer to Allah in the form of taqwa. Taqwa meaning the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, part of it is to polish ourselves by engaging in as much extra acts of worship as we can. So it's not just the five daily prayers. May Allah strengthen myself and all of you. It's not just the abstaining from food and drink. Together with that, we all know that when you have engaged in backbiting or abusing someone with your mouth or swearing them while you're fasting, the reward of that fast is minimized and even nullified in some cases. That would never be the case unless there is a great importance attached to developing yourself and correcting your tongue. And this is why let's cut out bad words. Let's cut out swear words. Many young people, and even the old, at our workplaces, with our friends, we swear and we don't even realize. Nowadays, people say it's no longer a swear word. Come on. That word will remain a swear word, even if society does not consider it a swear word. You can take it out of your vocabulary and you can use another word, perhaps. Even if it's just for laughter or banter, it's not necessary to utter words that are displeasing to Allah or that are low. They're not befitting a believer who's going to meet with Allah. Because the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, whoever believes in Allah and the day of reckoning, the last day, they believe they're going to go back and give accounts to Allah Almighty, should only utter that which is good or remain silent. So my brothers and sisters, if you and I are not going to be bothered about how we say things and what we say, and we're not going to be conscious of the words that come out of our mouths, then how could we be different from anyone else in terms of being believers? Let's try and make an effort. This Ramadan will be a Ramadan with a difference. There are a few days remaining. And even if we were to listen to this after Ramadan, still, we should develop ourselves now, because we don't know if we're going to witness another Ramadan. What is it that requires development? Well, I tell you. Number one, we need to ask ourselves regarding our connection with the Quran, regarding learning the meanings of the words of the Quran, regarding learning about the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. We need to respond to those who are coming up with things against Islam, against the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, that are not true, or taken out of context, or fabricated completely. Many people don't know, because they haven't taken the time through the years to study, to look into, and to check. I've had people who tell me, well, you know, I'm doubting this element. There was no need to doubt it if you had knowledge, because doubts are only created with ignorance. With knowledge, you won't doubt. So therefore, have you made an effort to learn? Have you joined an online class? Have you tried, be it online or even if it is in person? Have you made an effort to do something of that nature? If not, here is the time. Similarly, the adhkar, take a moment to repeat words of praise of your Lord. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. These are words of praise of Allah Almighty. Glory be to you. Praise be to you. You are the greatest. There is no might, no power except that of yours. And so on. Lovely words. Learn to repeat them. They will help polish you. They will make you conscious of what you say. Become a person who says lovely words, beautiful, empowering words to others. As you meet someone, you smile, you greet them, and so on. This is the teaching of Islam. Like I said, Islam teaches us to worship Allah alone. And then it tells us to develop ourselves in a way that we fulfill the rights of others. One of them is, for me, to develop and improve my character, my conduct, and to become a person who's much better than I was. So my brothers and sisters, Allah Almighty's favor upon us is tremendous. He has given us something beautiful, holistic deen. The month of Ramadan comes and Allah expects us to have improved. Allah expects us to enjoy the prayer after Ramadan because in Ramadan we took it seriously and we increased so much in the month of Ramadan. Now after Ramadan, I'm finding it so easy to fulfill these five prayers. I'm finding it so easy to control my temper because in Ramadan, I controlled it so well. I was hungry, it was hot, there were so many things going wrong, but I kept myself and I controlled my temper. Here I am out of Ramadan, beautifully, I can manage. And that's why the hadith says, when in Ramadan, someone swears you, you look back at them and say, Inni sa'im, I am fasting. That's it, I'm fasting, which means don't come and try this with me. At the moment I'm fasting, and even when I'm not fasting, the fact that now I learned how to deal with this type of behavior will make it much easier for me to deal with it even outside of Ramadan. So you look at the benefits of this beautiful month, it's tremendous. We become people who are connected to the right things. Then we have certain things in our lives we know we have to get done for the sake of Allah. Perhaps in my dress code, I need to improve XYZ. I need to make sure I get to this level. Let's be strong. Ramadan is a season where good things begin. Start it now and don't give it up. You know what you need to do. Today, we make a decision and we say, oh Allah, I have not been doing this like I gave an example of a dress code, perhaps male and female. I've been dressing in this particular way. I'm supposed to be doing this. From today, I'm going to do this and I'm not going to give it up. There we go. And I'm doing it for your sake. I'm going to make my clothing in a way that is modest and acceptable in your eyes. So when I meet you, I know that you will be pleased with me. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that this was so simple to do, he would not have kept such a great reward in adopting his instruction. And that's why whenever you find something really difficult to do that you have to do and you do it, you're rewarded more than a person who found it relatively easy because of your situation. Say, for example, you're living in an environment where it is very difficult to do certain things that you need to do. Very difficult to do certain things that you need to do because of the environment. And you do those things against all odds. You would be rewarded more than a person who lives in an environment where that particular thing is very easy to be done. Because number one, you're rewarded for what you've done. Number two, you're rewarded for the patience that you bore. And you're rewarded for the strength that you developed in order to do the right thing that was not easy against all odds. So there's a double, triple, quadruple reward for you. So therefore, take these in your stride. Allah Almighty knows what's best for us. Really, He wants us to develop ourselves. He wants us to be strong. He wants us to carry ourselves on in the best possible way. Think good of others. That is something that is lacking in today's society. The minute we see a negative thing from someone, immediately shaitan comes to us and makes us think negative and only negative, not realizing the term giving them the benefit of the doubt is actually something Islam teaches. If there is a doubt, give them the benefit of it. If you want to address a matter, address it in a beautiful manner. But you don't have to accuse people based on a doubt. Think good of others, and inshallah you find the world will be a much better place. Give others a chance. Help them and see them develop. Even if someone has a weakness, don't we all have weaknesses? Imagine if all of our weaknesses had to be exposed. It would be embarrassing to even communicate with one another. But this is the favor of Allah, where He has hidden a lot of our weaknesses from others because He wants us to develop and to correct them. So we will be judged by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on how we were at the end of our lives. We still have some time, inshallah, although we don't know how long. But the fact that we're awake right now, we're alive right now, we're alert right now, we can make an intention by His will to change for the sake of Allah, to develop for the sake of Allah. And the way we look at others, like I say, needs to be positive, in a positive light. There is a narration where the Prophet, peace be upon him, says, a true believer should never be bitten from the same source twice. Once you've been bitten, take heed. But that doesn't mean that you need to write off the person completely. Perhaps that particular item, watch out that you're not bitten a second time. If you can offer help to people, offer it. If you can help develop them, help develop them. And see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does for you in your own deeds, in your own lives, and in the lives of those whom you love. Allah will help develop all of those by His will, His favor, and His mercy. May Allah grant us ease in this world and the next. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَصَلَى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ وَبَارَكَ عَلَى نَبِيْنَا مُحَمَّدٍ
ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر